Oh boy. Okay. Well, that's not good. Today we're gonna talk about the Synology. It's a NAS system where I can actually store all of my footage and pictures, photos, whatever, all of my projects into this big guy here, so I don't have to, you know, stack these like hard drives everywhere around on my table. Whenever I'm editing and whenever I'm trying to look for files, all I have to do is put everything in here and just update this guy with all these hard drives separately. So what is a NAS? A NAS is a network attached storage where you can store all of your stuff in here, and then you can also access them via the network from your routers. So the idea is to hook up the Synology NAS to my router via the Ethernet so I can access the files between my computer and the NAS over the network. So the reason why I went with Synology is because from the reviews that I read, it seems like Synology has a really easy learning curve, which is good for me because this is my first time getting to these kind of systems. So hopefully I can learn this in a short period of time. And also they have like a really good software that I can play around with. There's also a personal cloud backup feature. I'm also intrigued by the cloud station feature by Synology because theoretically, let me put this down. We're gonna open that up pretty soon here. So theoretically, I can set up a folder that continuously transfers files to NAS, and people who has access to the folder can edit them as well. All of the editing and changes on this folder will be updated right away on the NAS. Supposedly, there's also a mobile app that I can use to share files and put password or time limit on there. So that's gonna come in handy for me as well if I wanna share my work with clients. But I'm gonna have to play more around with the system and see how everything works first. So I got 4-6 terabytes to start with. By the way, it took me forever to disinfect all of these boxes. Two USB ports back here and then 4 Ethernet LAN connections. So the Synology I got is 1618 Plus, the one with the 6 bays. So right now I only have 4 hard drives, and then I plan to upgrade and then hopefully maybe add more hard drives to it. That's why I got the 6 bays instead of the 4 bays. And it seems like I'm gonna have to put all of these inside my closet in here because that's where the router is. I'm very excited about this. It's something that I never think I would be so excited about. But I guess in this case it's because I actually don't have to keep on looking for hard drives and think about like how much hard drives and spaces I need all the time now. See, for approximately 20 terabytes online for cloud storage subscription, it's about $200 a month. So it's definitely cheaper in the long run if you invest in a NAS system or RAID. Or both of them. I mean, that's what I'm doing right now. And seriously, if you don't take a lot of videos or photos like me, it's also worth getting one because all of your media or music or movies that you have, you can actually just store everything here and then have access to all of them anywhere you want in the world, as long as your internet doesn't die at home. All right, so apparently these little screws are the one that can screw my hard drive onto this case here so I can slide it in. And then these two here are the lock to lock the hard drive in there so I don't accidentally press it and then open it up. So let's open one up and see how this works. Great. All right, a quick update. For the 3.5, you don't have to use the screws. According to the instructions, all you have to do is snap those two plastic things back on the side and that is good to go. But if you have the 2.5, which is this one, then you have to screw all these stuff at the bottom of the hard drive. Well, good for us, we have the 3.5. I guess that's it. And then just do this 3 more times and then slide all of them in. Should be good to go. So I was thinking about the RAID system, how I'm gonna set them up. Seems like RAID 5, or maybe I'm gonna use the Synology version of the RAID. I think it's called SHR. That seems to be a better option for me because if I wanna update my hard drive or add more new hard drive, although RAID 10 seems to be like the best out of all of them, but it's a lot of money. And I don't think I need all of that redundancy. By the way, My hair situation is getting out of control. I need a haircut, like for real. It's like going everywhere. But I gotta say, some of these are really hard to pull out. Okay, I think we're good to go. I got all four of them ready to go. Let's put them in and see how it goes. They're actually quite heavy when you have all of them in your hands. It's up and running. So the first thing we're gonna download is the Synology Assistant. That's gonna help us throughout the setup process. So we're gonna open that and then, okay, open again. And you can find this on the Synology website. So it's really easy. And then there's a whole bunch more softwares that you can add to this. By the way, it is absolutely pouring outside. I'm not sure if you guys can hear it, but seriously, check this out. So when you're running the Synology Assistant, you wanna make sure your firewall is off, or maybe add that to your firewall so it doesn't block the software. And after that, it runs pretty smoothly. And now we're taken to this web assistant, and then it's installing Disk Station Manager. It's wiping all of my drives right now, but that's okay, because they're brand new, I think, I hope. So I think after this, I'll be able to manage my disk and then start setting up like cloud stuff and storage. I'm excited, I'm pumped. This is fun actually. I really hope this works. This is gonna improve my workflow so much better, and then I can access to the files I need anywhere I want. This is, wow, technology nowadays. It's very fascinating. Okay, 98%, it's almost done. Come on, let's go. 10 more minutes to restart my disk station.
A little later.
All right, so I'm gonna create an administrator account. Server name. Go with SuperNAS. Username, I'll put my name up there. Quick Connect is ready. Let's check on. So the phone version works too. All right, system health, good. Green check mark is always good. Let's go on the top here. I think that's where we want to create our raid. Like which kind of raid we want to go with. Okay, volume, there's no volume, let's create one. Choose a mode, quick. The system will create a SHR volume, which optimizes the performance and space allocation. Let's go with SHR. Let's do with, okay, so let's go with type 1. So we got 4 drive, looks good. All of them is 5.46 terabyte. Next, should I want to continue? Yes. PTRFS recommended. It's gonna allow us to share for the quota. Okay, let's do that one. Right, type SHR, drive 1, 2, 3, 4. Total capacity 16.36. Okay, that sounds about right since we're using SHR1, which allows you to have one drive fails and then still have all the data in all the other drives. And for SHR2 means it allows you to have 2 drives failure and still keep all the data in your drives. So essentially it's kind of like RAID 5 and RAID 6. It seems like it's going to take a long time for the verifying drives in background checking parity consistency. Okay, that's going to take a while. It's not even 1% yet. Alright, so while it's verifying the drives in the background, I'm gonna go to control panel and then share folder, try to create a folder and see if I can actually throw some files in there. Good, next, encrypt. All right, I like that. There's no way to rescue the encrypted data if the encryption key is lost. Okay, let's save the key somewhere else. All right, seems like Big Wolf is now set up. Let's try to put some folders in there, shall we? All right, seems like everything's up and running and then everything works. I just need to wait for this to verify my drives in the background to be over. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So I'll definitely play more around with it. And then there seems to be a lot more software than I expected. If you go to the package center, you can actually see there's a lot more to play around with. So I'm gonna dig in and start playing with it and let you guys know if there's any new updates or any interesting stuff that I find that's helpful, of course. All right, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.